like I ran up on a quarterback. Shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no farmers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunning.
Now the good news is that the winds aren't as violent as they were yesterday in Chicago, but it's still pretty darn cold to be expected, I guess, for December football at Soldier Field. Just a short time ago, this crowd loud enough to shake the foundations of this nearly century-old building. They are ready for football. Set to do battle with the Green Bay Packers. This is going to put them back with a not great field position.
So they really got zero benefit at all, right? Sometimes you can absorb a penalty when you get a big return, then the penalty brings it back, but you still have great field position. As you pointed out, not in this case.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it, and they're going to be set up in the red zone at the 15. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
After the interception, here's Trubisky to the goal line, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find Anthony Miller there. That'll bring up second down.
And to put it mildly, this is a tough spot defensively. They have to come right back out and defend their red zone. But how about that good first step towards forcing them to settle for at least 3 points? I think they're also thinking bigger right now. Imagine being able to stop them totally and change the momentum.
Again on second and 10, it's Trubisky. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And, oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So now after the face mask penalty, here's first and goal. Here's a run with Elijah, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. On second and goal, they'll give it to him again. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
Brings up third and goal.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. They'll run for the first time with Tariq Cohen. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Tariq Cohen with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Bears have taken the early lead. Able to punch it in on third down makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating what we have to make the call. They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. You know, in our research packet this week, prepping for the game, so many articles from the local beat writer. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. He's airing it out for Williams. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Mike Williams, his first touchdown on the year. And the Bears will extend their lead. So a one-handed grab in the end zone. Nothing much more rewarding than that for a guy catching it.
Not at all. And with what we just saw there, that type of a one-handed catch, what's next? Maybe they go up and almost Velcro it with their jersey in the ball. That's about all that's left. That play, simply spectacular.
So a one-handed grab in the end zone, not much more impressive than that. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Ball at the 24 and a second and 11. Almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Intended for. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
And they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
He's going to look deep down the field. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Marquez Valdez-Scantling.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first three drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
Call that a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and the Bears take over
at their own 36-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Now Ballage. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to Huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. From the gun, it's Trubisky. Gets this to his running back, Tariq Cohen. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
We often talk about understanding the playbook, understanding progressions, and understanding what the defense is doing. We saw all of that on that play. Great recognition and understood where his running back was going to be. Found a way to have him leak out underneath, hit him with the football, and they picked up the first down.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down for the Bears. Now look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up 2nd down.
And 10 at the Packers' 23-yard line.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10. Trubisky will throw. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. His first catch, good for 16 and a first. Great mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. 1st and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
This one into the hands of the running back, Ballage. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, 2nd down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
2nd and goal from inside the 5. Ballage. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Kalen Ballage with touchdown number 12 on the year. As the Bears push further out in front. What a first quarter. Boom, you're up 3 scores just like that, and the offense clicking.
And they're thinking to themselves, we can totally overwhelm this team. Now flip it over. They're going to get the ball back.
Yeah.
Can't panic here. Talk to yourselves one play at a time to try and get back in.
And that's cliche, but really that's the message. This is still very early on in the game. We're in the first quarter.
If you look at it as down 20, then you almost have no shot.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now?
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots, but what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
The drive starting with a 1st down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Packer, 1st down.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Danny Trevathan there to bring him down.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second down, it's Jones. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Roquan Smith in on the tackle. A two-yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
So now at third and seven, and defensively, it's a dime look. Six DBs. Out of the shotgun, it's Love. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. Here's J.K. Scott now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And a fair catch called for and made just outside the 15-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments. Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
18.
They run it with Balazs. It's a four-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. Now it's Trubisky. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. His first catch, good for nine and a first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs as we just saw there.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll run here with Balazs. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Shotgun handoff to Patterson, and he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down. All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has three options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football for triple option, you've actually called that play.
At the 49-yard line.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They go play action with Trubisky. Sliding out of the pocket. He's got his man on the crossing route. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 22-yard line. 27 yards there, a first down. Gun, he'll hand this off. And he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
At the 18-yard line.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a 10-yard gain there to set him up first and goal. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Now they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
On third down. It's Patterson. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. 4 yards, that gets him close to the goal line, but it also brings up a fourth and goal. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Eddie Pinheiro on now for the Bears. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. The kick by Pinheiro is good. And that will up the score now. It's 23-0. So they get three, certainly hoping for six after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second down, Love. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
24-yard gain on the play.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going to be
pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Khalil Mack, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
It's second down.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Working out of the gun. Love. And he's going to go down again. To credit that sack to Robert Quinn.
3 scores down, not even a halftime yet. They have not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Looking for 19 yards here on third down following 2 negative plays. Final play of the half, Love.
He's going to float this over the middle deep.
And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The final 2 quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So, 1st and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. And to give this time to the tailback, he takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
The ball carrier.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to have 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Again, it's Balaj. And he's got this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Packers 37. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on it.
Here to his running back, and not much running room out of the 32.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Now they try the right side here. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Bit of a surprise. They ran it on 3rd and medium. Proved to be the right call. 1st and 10. And they gave themselves options there on the 3rd down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10.
Check, check, check. Check it out, check it out.
They'll run with a former Ole Miss Rebel, Jordan Wilkins. And he's taken down after a gain of three as they move it from the 22 to the 19.
They're pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves and start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. And he'll give it here to his running back. And just a couple yards there down to the 17.
The ball carrier.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Toss play, Cohen, right side. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. Second and goal from inside the five. They'll stay on the ground. Balazs again. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Kalen Balazs with his 13th touchdown of the year and second of the game. And this offense is running away with this one. And the lead is now an even 30.
Makes the score Bears 30. Packers nothing. Eddie Pinheiro to kick off for Chicago.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. They'll go again to Jones. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
On third down, here's Jones. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. They've now produced 3 yard gains on three straight plays. Leads us to fourth down. Here's J.K. Scott now as he's on to punt for Green Bay. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. In on the tackle, Alex Okafor.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
Gonna give this time to the tailback, and he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now a handoff here to his running back. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two.
I know the game's not over, but there's got to be a sense of satisfaction right now for the guy carrying the football a bunch today. 99 yards, and he has enough time to go over the century mark.
Well, you got
to
give it to him again, right?
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You're not worried about losing yardage here. You're not worried about any of that. You just want to get him to the promised land for every runner, 100 yards or more in a game.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Now a give, right side. It's Wilkins, and he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
On second down, it's Cohen, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now third and 11 coming up. The Bears on third down. They have been superb, 5 for 6 to this point. This is third and 11. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
Oftentimes when you're losing a game and the team's still throwing with this kind of a lead, you start playing a little more physically. And they took that opportunity right there to be extremely physical and force that incompletion.
And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
And he's upended at the 6 as they double their room to maneuver on a pickup of 3. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up third and about six. Love now. And this is going to be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer.
And from their own end zone, it's a fake. And this is caught. Give him 2 yards on that play. And now, goodness, possession's going to go over right at the 10-yard line.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, they look like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
Hey, switch gears, switch gears.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
The play leads to second and goal at the 10-yard line.
They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal.
Let's go, let's bring it, let's bring it. 42's a mark, 42's a mark.
Out of the gun, running with Cohen. Yeah, this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11th. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
Under 10, under 10, 10.
Third and goal, the ball at the 11. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
This is up and good from Pinheiro. And that will just add 3 more to a lead that's already out of hand. So it's 3 more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
This will be fielded inside the 5. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
On the return, the Packers take over first and 10. At their own 27-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Well, I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on it.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. Xavier Williams able to get him for a loss of about 3. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he didn't have a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
You
yeah.
See what I did there?
Yeah. He needs better protection, that's for sure. Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Bears are going to get the football back, and they're going to get it in great field position. And they take a knee.
Trubisky on the keeper. It's a loss of a yard. Brings up second and 11 at the 25-yard line.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you. 58's the mic. 58.
And they will take a knee here.
Trubisky on the keeper. It's a loss of a yard. Bringing up third and
the chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. And they'll indeed take a knee.
Well, they certainly didn't appear to be fired up about their options throwing the football. So, to me, this seems like a case of just kind of taking their medicine there, run the ball, see if they could pick up something. Instead, they were thrown for a loss.
Today's final score.
Bears. So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. So for the Bears.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my juke.
Damn, Kane, you done kill Abel. Unbalanced land, trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might f*** it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the bug. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee. Rolling thunder, don't hear my cry, don't let Allah. To realize, never give up and coexist. I can't watch TV. It's all a lot tired of trying. Go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time. Infrastructure, I don't got time. I could all to what talking about your brother protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out because I'm on fire. I can't give a f- about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my juke, you can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got different views. Just know you gon' pay the price, best up the item you choose. When it ties in the culture, hit you with them K-Ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't trust you, shock you, deny you, fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered, doing this so subtle. Falling out through the rubble, remember this in jungle. The top, I was gonna get something, the middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Why the rush up for nothing, why the rush up for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. Under the institution, modern day execution. Think I know the solution. Maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music. Just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.